My view is, first of all, it's not our job to impose our wishes or fears on the universe. Our job is to understand what the universe is really like. This universe is one of an enormous number, maybe even an infinite number, of other closed-off universes. So the idea that we are central, that we are the reason there is a universe, is pathetic. We have to simply come to grips with the real universe that we really live in. And if some of our myth and some of our religion is inconsistent with it, it's time to change the myth and the religion. Messages are being sent to us by civilizations on planets of other stars. So far, although there have been some very curious, tantalizing findings in both of those approaches, we have found nothing definitive, unambiguous evidence for extraterrestrial life, and the debate is still open. In our ignorance, the geocentrists still find. Think of all the uncertainties and turmoil and terrors of our life, which would be made less terrifying if this were true. But here, if anywhere, is a case where we must not believe because we want it to be true. Now, if you take a look at Darwin, you see a case where it was so tempting to say, I find the watch. Expect the universe to go on forever into the future. Why do we have the idea that it doesn't go on forever into the past? I'm not saying I know the answer to this. This is one of the deepest questions. We do not know the answer. We simply have to keep an open mind. All of us, philosophers, scientists, religious people, no one in fact knows.